Here's a very talented and attractive actress who's appeared in such movies as Awakenings and Kindergarten Cop, and she co-stars with Danny DeVito in a movie called Other People's Money, which is playing around the country. Would you welcome Penelope Ann Miller? Very nice to see you again.
Thank you. It's nice to see you.
You know, the other night, easy. Watch the hormones, fellas. Just take it easy. You know, I have to apologize. I butchered your name one night on the show.
Yes,
and for some silly reason said Penelope.
Yes.
Penelope Ann Miller.
And in return, I called you Johan.
Johan, yeah.
Yes.
I don't know why I would say that. Penelope, is it?
Penelope, yes.
It's never been Penelope, has it? Until I did it.
Until you did it, yes.
Is that a family name?
No, actually, it's a Greek name. But my family, they're from Texas, so it doesn't relate at all. Well, actually, my father's side of the family is from Texas.
Well, you don't have any Texas accent at all.
Well, because I wasn't born there.
That would account for it. Here.
But we did actually have a family reunion, and it's hard, and there was about 95 of us. So
did you know most of them?
No, actually, I didn't. No. I've only met a few, and oh, by the way, I must say that my father is your age. Wait a second.
I hope there's a nice finish to this.
There is. Okay.
Okay.
And he just had a baby, which means that he can have sex and he can.
Of course. Men into their 70s and 80s have fathered children.
Right. So I just want you to know, in case you were thinking of
it. No, I'm not thinking of it. No, I try not to think
of it. But, you know, everything's still working.
Well, that's good. Yes. Well, thank you very much.
Yes.
Yeah, it's open 9 to 5, too. Yeah. Anyway, were you comfortable in Texas? Was it?
Well, you know, I thought I was talkative and loud.
Right.
But when you're in a room with 95 of your relatives, I mean, it was really quite, I mean, I sort of had to go around with earplugs because they're all loud.
You know?
They're all very loud. And it's funny because, you know, now I'm working in films, and so it was really strange because they're my relatives, and they were really sort of a little bit fascinated by me, so I was sort of a little bit alien. And, you know, at the end, they were asking me for my autograph, and I just sort of felt how strange. And, but at the same time, they were also inquiring about what I do with my spare time, and I was telling them a bit about the fact that I like to do astrology, and well, I don't do it, but I go to astrologers and
you
psychics.
You believe in that? You believe in psychics?
Yeah, I think we're all psychic, actually.
Yeah?
Yeah. I mean, I just think some people are more highly developed in that area.
You ever had a psychic experience of any kind?
Well, yeah.
Out-of-body experience?
No, I've never left my body. Have you?
No, I had an out of pants experience. I really haven't.
But you know, it was funny because I was talking about this with my relatives, and I thought they were fascinated by the fact that I did tarot. You know, that I went to people who did tarot cards and who did astrology, and then later I found out that they were a little bit concerned and thought that perhaps I was devil worshiping. Because
Satanism,
they're very
right?
religious and they're Baptists, and I love them dearly, but I do not worship the devil, and I do not believe that it really is the same thing.
Yeah.
I mean, it's a spiritual thing.
There's nothing wrong having an interest in astrology. I don't
know
if there's any validity
in
it, but it's
fascinating. But I think there is validity to it.
In astronomy?
You
astronomy.
Don't. So
no, but I think there's validity in astronomy. I don't think there's much in it. No, in astronomy, not in astrology.
Oh, okay.
I think it's fascinating, but
I'm fascinated by it. And actually, I've had psychics predict things that have happened, like getting films and stuff like that. So,
yeah.
I mean, I have seen it work.
Yeah.
And there's times where, you know, when the phone rings, you know who it's going to be, or you're thinking of somebody and you run into them the same day.
Couldn't that just be a coincidence? Couldn't that be happening?
I knew you were going to say that.
See? <Yeah. laughs> Anyway, we got a little film clip from this Other People's Money, right?
Yes.
I think we'd like to show this. Do we?
Okay.
We're going to set it up. Yes, sirree.
All right. Well, Danny DeVito plays a corporate raider, and I'm the lawyer that's come in to defend the company, and Gregory Peck owns the company, and I'm trying to manipulate Danny DeVito into not
compromising situation or something?
Well, a little bit. Well, there's sort of a little romance that brews, but anyway, I think that it doesn't lead up to that moment, but you have to see the movie so that you see where this leads to. But it's in a Japanese restaurant.
Here it is, Mother People's Money. Watch the monitor.
Thank you. You got any bread?
No bread.
No bread. They got no bread. They want to run the world. They got no bread.
In 3 weeks, you present your own slate. If you win, you buy everybody out at 20. If you lose, you sell us back your shares at 15. Worst case scenario, you still make a couple million.
Amazing people, the Japanese. We blow the hell out of them. They go back to school, learn English, and start to run the world. And what do? We get big-headed, start living the good life. Forget about schools. People can't read, people can't write. Country's full of dropouts. Education. Who needs education as long as you can blow up the world? Meanwhile, I got everybody in my office learning Japanese. I've never seen such a beautiful lawyer.
Come on, Lawrence. This is your game. Winner takes all.
And where it goes from there, you'll have to find out, right?
Yes.
Yeah. You're not that good actress.
Thank you.
What do you got coming up besides Other People's Money, which is already out, of course? Are you working on something now?
Well, I just finished a movie in Europe that I think the title will be A Very Good Year. And it's about wine, but it's also about me. And and anyway, I go to Scotland and London and France, Nice, France.
I hope it's a real good year for you.
Well, thank you.
We'll be right back.